to game two of a best of three
The dream
between
team
I'm a
is getting
Helicopter and
someone
Columbia
now.
University. Columbia University won the first game. Now they're gonna swap sides. Radiant still has first pick. And it looks like I'm a Helicopter
Dragon
going
is
for
getting
similar
someone
bans
now.
from last game. Same. They didn't ban Invoke. They banned
Radiant
Invoker
team
first instead of
burning.
Earthspear, but actually banning out the Spectre here. Respect
Fire
instead of
team
the
burning.
Invoker. Still not sure what that Earth Spirit's about. And Broodmother, Anti-Mage, these are just Hanging
Warriors
Sky
team pick.
bans that he just doesn't want to play against these heroes. I think it's fine. They're not really targeted at anything, he just doesn't have a desire to play against the heroes. I'm interested to see what Helicopter does with their first pick advantage here. There's a lot of strong heroes in the pool. I'm looking at Invoker that they didn't ban because they do have first pick on their own. Maybe they're looking at Invoker as well. I wouldn't be surprised if they picked up Invoker here first. They could lead off with another
5 seconds
support though.
remaining.
I think the AA was really strong for
Nightstalker.
Columbia last game. Started a lot of
Dire
fights
team
for them.
pick.
Actually gonna be a Nightstalker first pick from Helicopter. That's really interesting. I don't know. Maybe they're looking for a lot of ganking plays. I don't know why they picked Nightstalker so early. See what Columbia counter that. Looks like Hanging Sky a little confused as well, thinking a little bit about what he wants to pick.
Seconds
We'll see
remaining.
what he picks up here as he goes into reserve time. Vengeful Spirit
Ursa
and
Warrior.
Ursa picked up here by Hanging Sky.
Radiant team
I can
pick.
already see what he's thinking here. He probably just asked Calypso what he wanted to play, and Calypso said Ursa. Then he picked Vengeful Spirit because he knows I'm a Helicopter liked the Venge because they picked it up so early last game. And maybe Hanging Sky wanted to play Venge. So, while I'm gonna do a slight draft analysis on Columbia's draft, I think they're being a little cocky here, so the draft may be a little
Five
questionable on
seconds
their side,
remaining.
especially since they saw Nightstalker first pick, which is questionable on its own.
Reserve time.
So, they don't care. They're just gonna pick what they wanna play. Nightstalker more flanked by I'm a
The
Helicopter.
green team's banning
Really
someone now.
interesting. AA
Dire team
banned out
pick.
by Helicopter. I'm not surprised whatsoever that AA was doing so much work last game. We'll see what Columbia bans out. Nightstalker, Morphling, probably two cores. Nightcrawler, both of them are flexible, although Support Morphling is really weak, so I don't think it'll be Support Morphling. I think if it is a Support Morphling,
5 seconds remaining.
Columbia is going to be just happy with that. So, Morphling does show a core. I
Reserve
think you still
time.
pick to counter as if it's a support Morphling. And
Radiant
Nightstalker
team
obviously can be
banning.
support or core. And I think Nightstalker is just fine in both positions. So, it's a little quite curious. Invoker going to be banned out by
Bad team
Helicopter.
banning someone
And
now.
Tide now banned by
Dire team
Columbia, so they
pick.
don't want to deal with the Tide. Zeus banned earlier. Wraith King picked up here by Columbia. Are
Radiant
they gonna
team
go for a
pick.
level 1 rush? This looks like a level 1 rush. I think this is gonna be a level 1 rush. These three heroes by themselves can do level 1 rush. I'm a Helicopter. I really hope you don't go level 1 rush, Columbia, because this is like the most obvious shit ever. And if I'm a Helicopter just walks in there and kills you, you're gonna be off to a rough start. I think Columbia, if they have a even draft somewhat without some
Five
disastrous thing
seconds
happening
remaining.
early on, they'll pull it out. I think their general skill level is just slightly higher from what I saw last
Reserve
game in
time.
terms of execution, so my throat's a little sore. Don't really want to cast a third game, so if you lose this game, Hanging Sky, I'll be very mad at you. I know you'll be watching this replay later.
Dire team pick.
OD picked up here from I'm a Helicopter, a really strong hero in general, but this shows so much of their core, and really it doesn't look like they have a game plan. Everyone's just sort of individual hitters, maybe just have a bunch of people who can hit stuff really hard. Let's see what Columbia pick up here for their Roche strat. Who's next? Who's next? I would like to see Omni Knight, maybe. Omni Knight plus Ursa is really strong. Wraith King. You can run the Omni as like a... You can run dual lanes even with Wraith King and Venge somewhere, and Omni Ursa, or even Omni Wraith. Don't think it would be too bad. Since, I'm a helicopter is such a run at you and hit you team. Omni kind of prevents that from happening, so wouldn't be too bad. They have a lot of melee. I'm sure they might be a better option. See, looking for a support in a mid. Unless Wraith King's a support, Wraith King might be a support actually. So looking for a mid and offlaner. Weaver is gonna be the offlane. Okay, he's got another minus armor. So we've got minus armor. Oh man, this bug. Minus three armor, and then we've got minus one armor per hit on Swarm. We got a Vampire Gar, we got Fury Swipes. So, if I'm a helicopter, doesn't see this coming immediately, if they don't see this coming, if they didn't see this coming from just the Wraith King there, I don't know. Maybe it'll be a bait. Maybe they'll just all walk in the rush pit and just wait there for someone from I'm a helicopter to show up, just get a nice kill. That could happen. We'll see. Shadow Demon picked up here from M Helicopter. So maybe they've got some strat coming out here with Morphling Replicates and Disruption Illusions, and I don't know. I'm not sure what M Helicopter draft is all about. Dire's draft is just kind of obviously a Roshan lineup, low on Rosh lineup, and then snowball from there. I think it's kind of weak, but I think I'm a helicopter's draft isn't exactly quite strong either, so we'll see. I don't think Dire's draft is too weak. They've got a lot of stuns and damage. They don't have a lot of AoE though. Might be an issue with a lot of illusions coming out from everywhere. Like you have pretty much no AoE whatsoever. Actually, a little bit of an issue. OD has a lot of damage. I think I'm a helicopter's draft panning out a little better. We'll see what they pick last. Murana was banned by Columbia, they don't want to deal with Shadow Demon Murana. I think Nightslogger is going to be a core. So, I think I'm just looking for another support. Viper banned out here from Helicopter, not sure what that's about. I'm going to pick Windrunner for Jesse. You can Windrun to take Rush for 3 seconds. Alright, let's see if they TP out or what they do with this draft, but it's a very obvious rush attempt around the Dire side. And let's see what I'm a helicopter pick up. They're really lacking on disables. They're actually really lacking on disables on this side. They've got Dire's got a lot of disables. Shackle, stun, stun. Disruptor picked up here, so no stuns. No stun lineup. No stun gaming coming out here from helicopter. Unless you count Morphling stun, but it's a core Morphling, so it'll be agility. No stun gaming. Yeah, I don't think it's gonna work out well for a helicopter, and we'll see how this low on rush shit works for Columbia. Alright, let's do some introductions. See their item purchases. Cosmos on the Weaver, Jesse on the Windrunner, Calypso on the Ursa, Hanging Sky on the support Wraith King, and finally Trojan Horse on the support Venge. On the other side, we've got Multilinear on the mid OD, Katos on offlane, presumably Nightstalker, Rizad on the support Disruptor, Packrat on the support OD, Shadow Demon, and Webs on the carry Morphling. And Smoke actually here popped immediately by Helicopter, so looks like they know. All of Columbia heading down towards the Roshan pit area, so I think Helicopter might actually get there first. What are the items? There's a lot of salves here. I do get two salves on Calypso, but this is level 1 rush. Thanks guys, gonna be able to drop a word here, but this is a smoke here. And did they see? Oh my god, are you actually? No, Columbia. Oh my, oh nice shackle here on a Packer, and Packer actually falls first. Calypso has taken a lot of damage, so he's gonna fall, and it looks like Columbia's gonna get wrecked here. A lot of damage here. Jesse's gonna fall as well. Stun here on Cosmos. They're looking to make a return kill on Rizad, but Hanging Skyfall, that's three. Rizad finally eventually falls. Trojan Horse actually kills off OD, so it's not too bad. 3 for 3. Trojan Horse is gonna fall as well. 4 for 3, but Overall, not the worst. And Calypso's back. He TB'd in. He's looking to make a play on Kaitas, and he's way faster, but he's just going to get this rune and get on. Not too bad for level 1 engagement. Nice shackle from Jesse here. I can't believe they actually went for it. That was so obvious. And I'm surprised Helicopter didn't punish it harder. I think Shadow Poison is a spell there. I think Disruption was a bad choice. Shadow Poison, they're all clumped here. They get tons of damage. So I really think Shadow Poison was the pick here for Packrat. So I think Disruption, not so great. On the other side, Kinetic Field is okay, but they're all clumped. I think you just want to maximize damage because you're going to catch them. And the other skills are pretty fine. Dank out of 10. Some BMs, all chat coming out here from Packrat. And it is going to be dual lanes as I predicted. for Columbia, although I did want them to pick up Omni as a dual lane for the off, but I guess it's too much melee. They'd pick a Weaver instead. Mid lane, Jesse versus OD, Windrunner versus OD. I think pretty even matchup. I think Windrunner a little favored because now you can't steal intelligence from Astro, and you can Windrun dodge the arcane orbs. So I think Windrunner is favored in this matchup because before it was OD favorite, obviously. Windrunner, intelligence hero, just can't right click out, but now I think it's Windrunner favorite. Excuse me. Top lane, Night Stalker, really fast hero with his boots picked up, but he can fall quite easily. We've got a lot of stuns and slows here, so he needs to be really careful with his positioning. And because it's dual lane on this lane. Wait, what? Hanging Sky looking to make a courier snipe play as Wraith King. He's got boots, so should be able to do it once it comes out. Gold status on multilinear. Jesse's denying too much. Let him get some more. Last hit, swinging his bottle. And it looks like Ursa's again. Calypso just farming a lot better than the carry player on side of Helicopter. Webs only has 3 last hits. Getting pressured up a lot by Weaver. Weaver really hard to deal with no stuns. No stun lineup, no stun gaming against the Weaver. And I think it's gonna be rough for Helicopter. And Hanging Sky just sitting here not doing anything. Trojan Horse making rotation now, so they're leaving Ursa up top by himself, and he's doing okay, so I don't care. Hey, this guy's getting tired. He's thinking, he's like, where the fuck is this courier? The answer is the courier isn't there because OD's not rich. And bottom lane, a kill. Looks like Weaver wanted to make a play on a support. It's going to be a return kill for Weaver, but I don't know. That's okay, that's worth it. Ping's coming out here. Hanging Sky gonna come out. Stun goes on multilinear. He doesn't have Astro, so he can't self Astro. Looks like they stacked stuns a little bit, but it's probably gonna be enough. Shaka Shot not gonna latch, but one more hit. Mid lane, nice kill here. TP in from Rizad, but a little late. Not gonna be enough. And Flying Courier here, so Hanging Sky wasn't gonna be able to get that bottle, but got it even better. Got a kill. Now, the support's rotating up to the top lane, so it's going to be a tri lane. They're leaving Weaver by himself on this bottom lane. And usually, Weaver shouldn't die in that lane, so it looks like he just wanted to get a kill and then got punished here. Top lane, Night Stalker, a little far out, no wards here on this whole area, so didn't see the support rotation. And just 2 quick stuns to kill. Now, Rizad's here. Ward seen by Jesse. Moving up to top lane to try to get this rune. Wait. How does Jesse know? I don't know. Looks like they're gonna make a play on the Windrunner. Maybe not. Hanging Sky grabs an arcane rune on this top. And Jesse gonna bottle Crow instead? I don't know. Phase Boots already picked up by Calypso. You look here at the CS, it's already pretty strong in favor of Dire. We've got a pretty big gold lead here. The offlane Cosmos is pretty happy too with this no stun gaming lineup from Helicopter. And they got Disruptor just hanging around on this mid lane trying to save the, protect this OD. It looks like they're putting a lot of eggs in this OD basket. Glimpse used way too early, so it's not going to be a kill. And I don't think it would have been a kill anyways, it wind run. I'm surprised he even let OD get a single hit off. I think he just wind run and don't let the OD steal any intelligence. When you win the lane. Like Hanging Sky gonna be make a rotation. That's gonna be seen by this ward here. So Odie needs to play a little careful, and like he's hanging around on the bottom side of the lane, because any rotation from Wraith King will be coming from this side. But Wraith King can just move back around, and is this ward? Did this see him? Does that have vision? Doesn't, because it's nighttime, so it won't see Hanging Sky rotate out. So Rizad's gonna be multilinear rather, is gonna be a little careful, because he doesn't know where Hanging Sky is. Stun here happening on Keitas. Keitas looking to make a play. This ward's gonna catch out Hanging Sky, and Keitas is gonna get out with that move speed from Hunter of the Night. 2 points in it, actually, I'm surprised. No points in Crippling Fear. He's really fast, hard to kill. This ward here, Keitas should not fall whatsoever. More hits coming on Jesse. He's already used Windrun, so I gotta have it available to trade with multilinear. And TP coming out from Nightstalker. It is nighttime, so is it making a gank on Jesse? He doesn't have a silence though. Crippling Fear is really strong. It's a lot of your gank potential. Like, he's slow and Jesse just windruns away. Invis picked up here by Hanging Sky, but there's a sentry ward in the mid lane. Bing's coming out. Hanging Sky just gonna back up. And looks like Morphling doing a little better in farm now, but Weaver. We look at the compare the offlanes, Weaver is absolutely dominating compared to Nightstalker, who's just hanging around mid lane. Weaver is actually level 630, so even harder to kill. And with no point in Crippling Fear, I don't know what Nightstalker expects to do here on the bottom lane. There's no silence, could be a disrupt used, and yeah, that's exactly what I expected. Time lapse used, glimpse, but he just runs away. Like, no stun gaming. No Crippling Fear. Don't know what they expected from that. Mid lane, Hanging Sky. Looking to make a gank on multilinear. He's just been hanging around this area the whole time. Weaver looking to kill his courier. So close, 5 HP. Oh no. And Keitas here by himself. Weaver. They're pinging him out. They want to kill him. OD is here though. Oh no. Cosmos doesn't have mana for Scoochie. Or doesn't have cooldown rather. He's going to Scoochie out. But Hanging Sky will fall. Yeah, nice static field. Keitas taking a lot of damage from this swarm thing though. And Rizad, Cosmos actually going deep. Cosmos is gonna get punished for this. One more hit, pop on the Shadow Poison. Oh my god, no, he's got 1 point. 35 damage, he's gonna fall. Is he? Oh my god, he's gonna live. No. 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 Not punished for that. No stun gaming. I think you should. 2 points in Hunter Knight is not necessary. When you get one value point, you get 20%, 5% more, and 15 more attack speed. Not worth it. You could have Crippling Feared on that bottom lane gank, honestly. 5 seconds of no spells, and that's a dead Weaver. Not even 1 second of no spells. That's all they needed. Really unfortunate. I really, really, really disagree with this guy's Nightstalker build. And meanwhile, top lane goes down because he's just been rotating around all night and not really getting a lot done out of that rotation. I think 3 points in Void, obviously, because it's your damage, but no points in Crippling Fear against the Weaver. It's really rough. Calypso gonna look to run down Keitas. He's got a Phase Boots, had an Orb of Venom, but didn't get in range to Earthshock, so couldn't get him slowed. Got a lot of Columbia heroes on this bottom lane. 3 heroes on the side of Columbia, so looks like they're making a pretty happy with what Clips is doing here. He already got his Vlad's face. They're happy with mid lane as well. He's dominating this OD completely, 41-21. I expected this though. Windrunner is now favorite against OD because you can just dodge the hits. Bottom lane, 2 kills by Weaver. Diving, kills the supports, and Weaver may fall. He's taking a lot of damage. Whoa, walked into Morphling and he falls as well. Now Morphling 303, he may be the last hope for a helicopter at this moment. Everyone else is feeding. Nightstalker actually 212, not too bad. He's finally got his point in Crippling Fear, but had to take it at 6, so no darkness available for him. And Calypso smoked into Roche. Precasted overpower, so maximum efficiency here. And even if Radiant know it's happening, it'll be too late to stop it now. One more overpower, he just ults with the rage. Doesn't even want to use it. Just gotta hit it a couple times. It's gonna be a free rush here for Calypso. Now with this ult pop, they're gonna know, but it's too late. He's gonna get this rush on. Rizad here, gonna fall. He gets stunned up by Hanging Sky. Slowed by Ursa, and it's gonna phase up. And Rizad should fall here. That disruption is not gonna be enough to save him. Actually, is he? He's got phase in 2 seconds. It should be a kill. On the other side, looks like Weaver's trying to do something. He's still getting chased. Calypso may give up soon. There is a kinetic field, just use it. Oh no. Kinetic field is gonna be there. Calypso's gonna be stuck on a tower for a little bit. But hold that thought on this side. Packrat taking a lot of damage. Gets stunned up by Trojan Horse. Cosmos doing a lot of damage. And now they're just hiding under tower. Calypso hiding back here. And looks like a misclick. Astrode himself. Or maybe he was getting gone on by Calypso. Didn't wanna risk dying. So he Astrode himself defensively. With all these rotations, DD on mid-ranger mid, and that's a tower gone. It's not night, he doesn't have darkness. Not gonna be able to get a kill on Windrunner. TP in for Rizad, but his is two supports by himself. I don't think they're gonna be able to get anything done here. Cosmos just drops a Storm here, Packer actually TPing out, and Rizad's just stuck on his own here. Poor Disruptor. He is dead. He's just gonna die. Nothing the rest of these heroes can do. Webs just needs to get out and farm where no one is. There's a huge rotation here. 4 heroes from Dire on the bot lane, and looks like they're gonna want to take this tier 1 bottom tower, which is great. It allows Roshan control for the rest of the game, pretty much, in coordinates with that tier 1 mid going down. It should be pressured quite heavily. They should be able to get this tower with this push. Meanwhile, helicopter, yeah, whips. Moving on. Farming a little bit. Okay, toss. Farm a little bit. Level 7. No points in darkness. Okay. Okay. I don't like your skill build. I don't like his skill build, at all on this Night Stalker. I don't really play Night Stalker too much, but, you know, I don't know. Maybe it works for him, but I feel like it's just not very good. Got a blink completed on Jesse, so he's going to be able to get a lot of pickoffs with Shackle, Focus Fire, and also dodge ganks with the blink dagger available. Bottom lane, Ping's coming out. There's still 3 heroes from Columbia here, only Wes here. Morphling doesn't have points in Replicate, so he's not going to be able to get out. There's going to be 2 TPs here from Helicopter, and it looks like Columbia is going to back off. They see these 2 rotations because of these 2 nice wards here, so Shadow Demon and Nightstalker giving it away. Just not going to TP out. Windrunner having a grand old time, 64 last hits. She has a TP too. She's going to TP in, so it's going to be a 5v5 engagement on this lane. Ursa running in, he's got a Blink Dagger completed, and he's got his Aegis, so he's going to front line. That's going to be an instant kill onto Shadow Demon. Nice Shackle onto Disruptor long range. It's going to get actually stun on the Venge and wasted a little bit, but doesn't matter. They had enough damage to just kill off the 2 supports immediately, and the team fire potential for Helicopter is just lower. This is going to be a free tower. And I think they can go for more. There is going to be respawns on these supports. It's very early in the game, but again, no stun gaming. What are you going to do against the Aegis Ursa? I'm just so shocked by their draft that they would pick these heroes. And then, I guess finally there's going to be a Darkness skilled on Night Slugger. I'm just so shocked because it was so obvious what Columbia was doing with their weak. And I don't think Columbia's lineup is particularly strong. Anyway, it's hold that thought. Calypso gonna blink in, he's got Aegis, he doesn't care. Rizad's gonna die. Actually, defensive disruption here used, but this little bug should kill him. On the other side, Nightstalker trying to make a play, but no support here. And the bug gonna be cleaned up by some right clicks from the rest of the team, but that leaves Nightstalker high to dry. Ursa gonna blink in again. Defensive Astro from the OD gonna save him. Shackle onto a creep because he misclicked because of Astro. And Columbia just gonna claim this tower back up. They're happy with this. Looked like Trojan Horse was trying to make a swap play, but couldn't get in range, so they're gonna be happy with the tier 2. This will ensure Roshan's for future. And I think this Aegis should be expiring soon. Bad dudes, middle tower, everyone, So Columbia gonna sit back, wait for the next Roshan probably, and then go for more pushes here, but they're really far ahead. Oh my god, 12k gold lead, 10k EXP or 7.5k EXP lead. They're just so far ahead, yeah, and that's the Aegis expiring. Like Cosmos so scary at this point for supports on this Weaver. Doesn't even have a lot of damage. But just his skills alone is enough. And with the Lincolns, he's gonna be impossible to kill. How are you gonna? They have no stuns, and Crippling Fear is not gonna be useful at all. Crippling Fear, not use. You gotta use this first. That would have been a kill if you used it. It's a 5 second silence. He's gonna get away, or is he? Glimpse used here. Time lapse on Cosmos. That was a misplay from Cosmos, and he's gonna fall. However, on the top lane, there's gonna be a blink in. Looks like it's just quick blink shackle, focus fire, gonna kill off OD. But I think kills are more important here, pickoffs are more important here for Helicopter. Right, they're happy to trade one for one pickoffs when they're so far behind. It's just a little misplay from Weaver. He's actually going for Desolator, decided he didn't want a Lincoln Sphere. He can make those plays with Lincoln Sphere, but Desolator looks like he wants to pick off these supports a little heavy. I don't think you pick up the Perseverance though. Maybe a little back and forth, wasn't sure on the item and decided halfway through to the Lincoln Sphere you wanted Desolator instead because of how far ahead they were. It's just his net worth. And they're gonna be, Columbia is gonna be making a grouping up for this top lane. Looks like they want to make a push onto the tier 2. Sorry, excuse me. Or at least moving around in this area to try to get someone. No. Stun gonna go on to multilinear. He's gonna self astro. Does self astro, but now he's by himself. Blink in from Calypso gonna kill off Disruptor on the other end. That's gonna be a quick kill onto OD. Self astro won't save you when they're all tanky and all doing tons of damage. That's three quick kills for the Ursa. And that's a tier 2 mid gone away. That's the issue. There's no. They have a lot of stuff that keeps you there. Disruption, Astro. There's nothing really that. There's nothing really on Helicopter that, like, stun or to stop or anything. Only Kinetic Field to stop engagements or stop, yeah, aggression. I think you can't afford to self Astro there or self defensive disrupt. I think you have to do it aggressively and then try to get out. In any case, I think this game is pretty much over. Morphling got his Lincolns. I think he does have his Lincolns. Maybe he's just a little bit off. The recipe, yeah, he should have his Lincolns. So Morphling has his Lincolns, but if you look at the rest of the net worth, it's Morphling and the Dire squad. So Morphling by himself, I don't think is enough with just the Lincoln Sphere. 18 minutes in. They're pushing racks here even earlier than last game. Last game was early racks on its own. Glyphsal moving forward. Roshan should spawn soon. Two sentries here placed by two different heroes, so looks like made a call, didn't communicate on which hero. It's not a big deal. Just sentry ward. Lincoln's finally completed on Morphling. He needs to really get his Ethblade combo up and going. He needs to carry his team. Because things are not looking good. Columbia gonna be happy to wait till the next Roshan, and then Calypso just runs in by himself, confident that even if he does die, he will be able to respawn. I think they can afford to be very aggressive now because they're so far ahead, but gonna play it safe. Gonna grab the Roshan first. Do they know what's up? They do know it's up. The courier has spotted it. Hanging Sky. Looks like he's going for an Aghanim Scepter on the Wraith King. I haven't really seen that in play. But we'll see how that works out for him. Maybe we'll even see an Aghanim Scepter on Trojan Horse, and he'll be able to survive for Wraith King and with his own Ags. Calypso looking to make a BKB. Normally I would want to see a Blink Dagger here on the support Wraith King, but they've already got Blink initiations from Ursa and from Windrunner. Has his own Desolator, so. What's going on here? Is this a Desol flying out? So two Desols, for Columbia. They're not communicating much either about item build. I guess it's okay if they split push, they can have Desolators smacking on two towers at once. It'd be a very fast rush on, taken by Calypso, and they should just 5-man down a lane and win the game here. Just so far ahead, 15k gold, 10k EXP. Yeah, I would prefer just the Ags first here from Windrunner, but increase your pickoff potential. But they're playing around a little bit with item builds. They're so far ahead, they can afford to do it. Oh, stun, not going to be able to get there in time. If he had a blink instead of, you know, this Midas point booster crap, would have been able to catch him, but I mean, they're so far ahead, doesn't matter. Two TPs here. Looks like they wanted to catch Morphling. Morphling's going to get a TP out. He should have always have a replicate up, so he can just replicate out, so he doesn't have to risk getting stunned or something when he makes those split push plays. Now Calypso pre-used the overpower. Looks like he wants to make a play onto one of these here. Blinks forward, off the mark. Won't be able to get much done here. And there's just three heroes here because of those two TPs on that top lane, so Columbia needs to be a little careful. 3v5, I think, even with Aegis, Helicopter may be able to win this fight. And Hangy Sky just jungling away, having fun, you know, they're just farming, waiting it out, they're so far ahead. And I think going into the late game, they're still pretty strong, but Helicopter is a little scary. They've got OD, who's monstrous in late game. Morphling is very strong in late game as well, and then they have a lot of vision for pickoff potential with Glimpse, with the Nightstalker Ags vision eventually. Columbia, while they have no pressure, they should try to end it at least the next 10-20 minutes. Not too much pressure on them. They're just so far ahead, they can do whatever at this moment. Maybe they want to wait. Maybe Hanging Sky captaining is right now. He's like, just wait, I want to get my Ag Scepter. I've never seen this before. I want to see what it looks like. Maybe that's what's going on. Trojan Horse building towards a mech. Jesse building towards his own Ags. Yeah, Hanging Sky just calling for them to give him room to farm. He's by himself, so they're trading farm. And well, never mind. There, it looks like they're making a attack onto this top, or push onto this top lane. It's Desolator damage. Blink in from Calypso. Self disruption onto the Shadow Demon, but he took a lot of damage. Calypso just turns his target, goes onto Disruptor instead. Disruptor dies instantly. He buyback. One hit from Windrunner, and that's gonna be a kill on the Shadow Demon. Two buybacks from support. Rakt is now blown wide open. Huge static storm onto two heroes. And Hanging Sky may fall, but he's got his ult. And there's an ult available. There's Aegis available on Ursa. And now that stun goes onto Multilinear. Multilinear self Astros on the other side. The three heroes are pushed back by the bugs. And Webb's actually going to get a kill onto the Venge with the waveform, and maybe they're going to be a pushback. Jesse taking a lot of damage. However, Calypso blinks in with his BKB, going to get a kill onto Shadow Demon. He's got his ult, but now it's about to wear off. He needs to be careful. He can't dive too much further. Rax is already down. Wraith King actually looking to go forward, but he's only have a level 1 ult, so he doesn't have his ult available again. And this may be a turnaround fight available for Helicopter, but no, Calypso comes in with a lot of damage. Astro here from Multilinear gonna make the adaptive strike miss, and a whole huge shackle here from Jesse gonna kill off the Windrunner. Now Webb actually replicates to the illusion right next to him. Katas looking to make a play onto Cosmos. Cosmos getting out. Calypso blinks back in again, but he has no mana. Shackle off the mark, but Katas gonna fall. Now Webb's going forward, gets adaptive strike. He's gonna kill off the Ursa, but the Axe finally completed on Hanging Sky. Now Ursa's got this sick illusion here, gonna be able to do a lot of damage. 5 hack from the Night Stalker, that's gonna kill off Hanging Sky, but now he's got his sick illusion. What does he do? Come on, stun. Oh, you don't have mana. Oh no, sick illusion is now dead. Sad life. And they just have a little fun here, doing some dives. I think they really could have just backed off after getting the tower. They gave a lot of money, I think, to Radiant, but they're so far ahead. It's just gonna be a slight dip. That was a lot of buybacks, actually. I'm surprised it's a slight dip up, because they bought back on, I think, every hero, let's look at buyback status. They bought back on 1, 2, 3, only 3 heroes actually. Not too bad. Still, 3 buybacks, and still, that's how far Columbia had. 2 kills, 3 buybacks, and you still get a gold lead. I believe it was more than 5 kills on the side of Columbia. Yep. And, yeah, now Columbia just waits for the next rush again. Further their gold lead while they're waiting, farming away. And, got Basher, soon to be a pistol on Ursa, so he'll be able to blow up anyone instantly. Ag's here on Jesse, so he's able to blow up everyone every 15 seconds. And we even got a mech here on Trojan Horse. They're just gonna, not even gonna wait for Roche. Smoke here, broken here on the side of the Radiant. There's gonna be a static storm coming up forward. Cosmo's gonna get caught in the static storm. He may fall, but Night Shackle here gonna instantly blow up the Night Stalker and the 2 supports dying on the back end. Calypso, Calypso gonna finish off the OD and the remaining hero. Morphling wasn't even with them in that fight, didn't even bother to replicate in. That's 4 for nothing, and that's probably gonna be GG. I don't see Helicopter not calling GG here. Maybe they just want to wait for Morph to try to get one nice shotgun kill onto maybe Trojan Horse. Cosmos, who doesn't have Lincolns yet, so maybe waiting for a shotgun kill here. Is he morphing all? He should morph all to agility. Nope, GG's gonna be caught. Not even gonna bother to try to get a shotgun kill with Deathblade finished. Maybe not 2 quick games for Columbia. Lincoln gonna get a nice final kill to end up the game with Ursa. 2-0 for Columbia. Very convincing wins here. Even though they did go for some cheesy level 1 Roche strat, it still panned out in their favor because Helicopter didn't draft any stuns. I think this Helicopter draft was extremely questionable.